Hello everyone, welcome to another module of Java Programming. In this module, Introduction to Programming, we will learn what is a program, what is programming language, and how the programming language is different than the machine language, the relationship between the programming language and machine language, okay? And then you will get to know why this programming language is important, why learning programming language is essential for the programmers. And in this video, we will talk about the difference between program and programming language. So first of all, you need to know the difference between a program and a software. They are correlated to each other, so please do not mix them up. So a program, it basically is a set of instructions, and it is written in a programming language. A set of instructions that is written in a programming language. And so which means it is a set of code, basically. And this set of code, it is designed to perform a particular task. Example of programs includes the applications such as the word processor, web browsers, and the games. Okay? And the software, and on the other hand, it refers to a broader category. Okay? It's a broader category of computer programs. It basically includes everything that is needed to run a program, such as operating system, libraries, and compilers. So those operating system, libraries, and compilers, as well as the debugs, all of them are needed in order to run a program. In another word, a program is just a type of a software. But the software, it includes not only the program itself, but also the documentations and any other resources that are required to operate a computer system. Okay, that's the difference between program and software. Next, let's talk about the difference between program and programming language. Okay, so a programming language, it is basically a formal language. It is used to communicate with the computers. Since it's a formal language, it provides a way for the humans to communicate with the computers and create the software by specifying the design, actions, and the computations. Okay? Every programming language has a set of rules and syntaxes to write the program. The rules and syntax of one programming language can be different than the another programming language. Okay? And without the programming language, you would have to use the binary codes in order to communicate with the computer. Because the only language that the computer understands is machine language. And machine language are written in the binary codes, okay? Which is a lot more difficult to learn and difficult for us to read. That's why learning programming languages is important in order to be able to communicate with the computers. You would rather want to learn a programming language, which is a formal language, than the machine language, which looks like an alien language. Okay? And here is an example which can help you to visualize and understand what programming language is. Okay? So if English is a programming language, then a chapter of a book written by this language can be considered as a program. And the whole book itself, a book composed of a bunch of chapters like this, can be called a software. Okay? This is some basic example of what programming language, program, and software is. So basically, software, it includes everything, not only the program, okay, but also the documentation and any other resources that are used to create this. Okay. And here are the key points and things that you need to know about the programming language. So programming language, it basically provides a way for us to express algorithms and computations. And programming language have a set of rules and syntaxes. If you want to be able to write a program, you need to follow the rules and syntaxes of that specific programming language. Okay? And programming language, it do not belong to any, it does not belong, programming language, they do not belong to any softwares, okay? Any type of softwares, not even the programming softwares. So programming softwares basically refers to the IDEs, which can help you to write your codes, write your source codes, okay? And the programming language, the most popular ones, it includes C#, C++, Java, Ruby, JavaScript, and Python. Okay, those are the most common, popular programming languages out there. Okay. And the next, let's talk about the different types of programming languages. Okay. So many languages, they share similarities. Java, Python, JavaScript, for example, they do have some similarities. They are readable compared to the machine language, right? And they also have, they also share some similar keywords and some similar syntaxes. But each of those programming language has its own syntax, okay? And once a programmer learns the programming language rules and syntaxes and structures, then the programmers can write their codes, write their source codes in a text editor or in a programming software. Programming software means by the IDEs, the integrated development environments, which you will also learn it very soon. Okay. Basically can help the programmers to write the codes in faster way and it can improve the efficiency. Next, let's talk about the high level and low level programming language. Okay. What does high level and low level means by? Well, the higher the level of the programming language gets, the more it is closer to the human language than to the machine language, which means it becomes more readable. Okay. So the highest level of programming language we have are like the language like Python, Java, and JavaScript, which means those languages are much more closer to the human language than to the machine language. Okay. Therefore, it is much more readable. And the low level programming language, you see, this is the low, these are the low level programming language at the ones that are at the bottom. The lower the level it gets for the programming language, the more it is closer to machine language than the human language. Okay. It's the vice versa basically compared to the high level, language. And if it is more closer to the machine language than to the human language, that means it is less readable. Okay? Because it basically means it's not the formal language, it is in the binary codes. It's closer to binary codes, and binary codes are hard to learn and hard to read. Okay? But of course, the high-level programming language, they also have some disadvantages. Okay? The higher the level of the programming language gets, the slower the language becomes. Okay, the processing this language, compiling it, running it, everything will be much more slower. Okay, but if the programming language level is low level, that means it is much more faster because it's closer to the binary codes, to the machine language. It's much more faster to process. And of course, in our next video, you will be introduced to those terms such as machine language, binary. Then you will understand what the language closer to machine, why the language closer to machine language than the human language are the fastest ones, and why the language that are closer to machine language are harder to read compared to the language that are closer to the human language. Okay. Thank you so much. I will see you all in the next video.